every company is looking at the next level of productivity gains. So when you look at RPA, companies look for various kind of metrics to improve productivity gain, to reduce errors, to reduction of cost, to improve cycle time. But most importantly, what companies are looking for is to become a digital enterprise, meaning scale digitally. And you cannot become a digital enterprise without being your operations becoming digital. You can have your front end digital, but if your engine room is not digital, your operations are not digital, you can't become a digital enterprise. And in order to make a digital operations, you want digital processes. And for that, the digital workforce becomes the lowest common denominator. It becomes the key factor that allows your company, your entire organization, your every system, everyone to become, to get on this digital enterprise path. So those are the factors that companies look for. And then they measure those. They measure in terms of, as I said, productivity gain, the compliance, the error reduction, the governance, and improving customer experience by reducing the cycle time. Generally, all these journeys are divided into three phases. We call it start, scale, and transform. And in the start phase, initially people get to the first 50 odd robots. In that phase, the whole challenge is all about education, awareness. How do you get the organization understand what it can do, what it can't do, how to utilize it, and how this can permeate across the whole organization. It cuts across everything. So the initial part of challenge is all about training, education, learning. But as this journey scales, it has a virality to the organization. And the real challenge that organization faces is that once some bot starts working in some department, everyone wants a piece of it. And generally, how do you curtail that demand and still grow very fast? That becomes the next challenge. So those are the interesting part where all our clients start in some place, but it scales at a very, in a rocket ship way in every program. Four years ago, we looked at RPA and we said, what next? How do you grow the whole thing? And we said, we went back to the definition of work itself. And we asked ourselves, what is work? As leader in the space, we had to define what's the next level. And we said that work, modern definition of work is we think about things. We do something about it, often on a computer. We analyze things. We drink coffee or tea and we call it work, right? So we decided to combine three different technologies. RPA allows you to do everything on a computer that a person can do. We decided to create our cognitive technologies, which allows you to create, think like a person. We call it IQ Bot. And we embedded real-time content analytics called Bot Insight, which allows you to analyze like a person. When you combine these three technologies, you form a perfect digital workforce that can not only augment a person, but it can automate any process end-to-end. Because when your data is unstructured or not in systems or semi-structured, you require cognitive technologies to bring that data out. So it's the combination of AI, cognitive, and RPA, when you look at it both side by side and work them together, allows you to automate every process end-to-end. The goal for automation anywhere is to make every process not only technically feasible to automate, but also economically viable to automate. And in order to achieve that goal across every industry, across every country, we had to combine these two technologies together. So it plays a very vital role, these two technologies working together. It creates a flywheel. RPA as a, it's a technology, I always say this, that this is a technology that can run at 100 miles an hour, but if you put it in a program that runs at 5 miles an hour, it moves very slowly. We recommend our customers to have more agile programs as opposed to the old school large scale integration programs, because customers have done these long integration programs and many times they use the same methodology to implement RPA. And the whole idea of RPA is that it can move fast, it's very agile, you can take it across the whole organization. So one common mistake we tell our customers is don't overboil things. You can start, think big, start small and scale fast. That's the better way to approach that. Second is that, again, the way enterprise software has been, it has always been only IT's main domain in most of the cases. Another unique aspect of RPA is that from automation in your perspective, at least our product, we have designed it for all three users, business, IT, as well as developers. And the idea is you bring the whole organization together in this program where everyone has a way to contribute, where your developers and IT are automating more complex process, but your simple and medium processes, even business, every business user can automate with attended and unattended bots. Doing that is another differentiation, and that's another thing that organization needs to adopt from a traditional mindset. These are some of the things that come to my mind. This is the most important question for every leader. If you ask me, at the highest level, automation has been in society for the last 60, 70 years, from cars to, first industrial revolution. Everything that we see around us, all these buildings, are because of a collaboration between man and machine, right? And we are seeking that same collaboration now in our offices. So it's nothing but a continuum journey of us as users and people trying to improve what we can do. Every automation journey starts with some doubts and fears, and rightly so. And I've told my customers that the best part is that instead of talking about it, onboard a few digital workforce, get few robots working. Because when that happens, that journey from nothing to something, from zero to one, it's a journey from doubts to possibilities. And once you have one or two bots running, and that's when we enter in our customer meeting, it's an amazing time, because suddenly from fear, everyone is saying, I can automate this, I can automate that. And we have seen that consistently. The best way to attack these fears is by getting on this journey and educating people that look how easy it is and how it improves your lifestyle. We have done studies where through University of London, where we have seen that everyone who has taken this journey on, their people well-being has improved by almost 38% or more. The productivity of the people is 33% more. It is a fact that automation is for people, it's not against it. That has been the fact when computers came, that has been the fact when internet came, and this is just the next level. And I have always seen that every people, everyone in their organization are very smart to understand it. We just have to get started. And every customer who gets started, I have seen nothing but excitement. There are bot parties, there are people who are working with them as digital workers, and I just see enthusiasm in all our customers' floors. So the fears are right, but once you get started, they get converted into possibilities and opportunities.